Hi all, myself Professor Disha Shukla and I am conducting the subject wireless communication. My today's topic is microcell concept. What do you mean by microcell? So we are already discussing about how to improve the coverage and the capacity of a particular wireless network, and in that we have seen two different methods, that is cell splitting and cell sectoring. Now, microzone or microcell concept is again a part of it. I mean, it is used to increase the or improve the capacity and the coverage of a particular wireless communication network. So, the increased number of handoffs, whenever we increase the number of cells or when we split a particular cell or we increase the cell size is smaller, then the number of handoff also increases. So, the increased number of handoff will increase the load on the switching and the control link because of the sectoring, and so the solution to this problem is given using the microcell zone concept. Large control base station is replaced by several low power transmitters on the edge of cell. That is, whenever we have a particular large control base station, it is replaced by several lower power transmitters. The mobile retains the same channel and the base station simply switches the channel to a different zone site, and the mobile moves from zone to zone. That is, whenever a particular mobile is in use, and it will be, what does it do is, it will retain the same channel and the base station. It will simply switch the channel to a different zone site. Now, since a given channel is active only in a particular zone in which the mobile is traveling, a mobile station radiation is localized and interference is hence reduced. So what happens is, because a given channel is active only in a particular zone in which the mobile is traveling, the base station radiation is localized. I mean, the base station has to radiate its power in a particular local area, and hence the interference occurred will be reduced. The problem associated with the sectoring technique is the increase in the number of handoff. That is, because the number of handoff are increasing, the problem associated, this is the problem that we face when we do cell sectoring. So this puts an additional load on the switching and the control link elements of the mobile system, and to this the solution is a microcell. Now, as you can see over here, we have divided a particular cell into three different zones: zone 1, zone 2 and zone 3. Now, all of them are the microcell zones. It has a transmitting power of TX and receiving power of TRX. Again, each of them has different transmitting power and receiving power. And this is a zone selector. A zone selector is something that will help you, that will decide in which particular zone a particular mobile will be radiating. And based on that, the base station associated with that particular zone will be linked up. Now, in this scheme, all the three or more zone sites are represented as shown in the figure, TX by RX, that is the transmitting power TX by radiating power RX, and all of them are connected among themselves. Now, the transmission medium that is used for connecting the zones to the base stations are coaxial cable or fiber optic cables or the microwave lines. All these zones are connected to each other using different transmission medium. They can be coaxial cable, it can be a fiber optics cable, or it can be a microwave link. So what happens is, so each of this cell consists of a base station and multiple zones. Because of this, each of them will be having base stations and multiple zones. Now, a mobile that is traveling within a cell is served by the zone that has the strongest signal of all. A particular mobile, when it is traveling within a particular cell, which zone will provide the signal depends on the zone that has the strongest signal. Now, as it is shown in the figure, the antennas in the zone are placed at the outer edge of the cell, and any base station can be assigned to any zone by the base station. Now, this proves to be a better approach than sectoring. See, as you can see over here, each and every antenna is placed at the edge of a particular zone. See, this is the antennas that are placed at the edge of the zone. So what happens is that any base station channel can be assigned to any zone by the base station, and it proves to be a better approach than sectoring. So as a mobile travels from one zone to the another within a cell, it uses the same channel. Now, this will avoid the handoff. which is another advantage over the sectoring. Thus, a given channel is being used only in a particular zone in which the mobile is traveling. Of the base station radiates its power in the localized manner. Now, this will reduce the interference. The channels are distributed in time and space by all the zones and are also reused in a co-channel cell. The microcell concept is very useful along the highways or in the busy or in a busy urban area. As a mobile travels from one zone to the another within the cell, it retains the same channel because we have created different zones. So the channel associated with it will be the same. The base station, it simply switches the channel to a different zone side, and thus what happens in sectoring does not happen here. That is, unlike in sectoring, a handoff is not required at the MSC when the mobile travels between the zone within the cell. The base station radiation is localized and interference is hence reduced. The channels are distributed in time and space by all the three zones and are also reused in a co-channel cell in the normal fashion. Now, this technique is particularly used for the urban traffic, and hence it decreases the co-channel interference, it improves the signal quality, and it also leads to an increase in the capacity without the degradation in the trunking efficiency that is caused by the sectoring. It is particularly useful for the urban traffic because there the traffic will be increasing and the requirement of moving from one cell to another cell will increase, and hence if we divide a particular cell into micro cell, then we don't need to create handoff, and hence it will improve the quality of the particular wireless communication network. So there are some of the advantages and disadvantages of micro cell. Some advantages are that it decreases the co-channel interference, which will lead to an improvement in the signal quality, and it will also lead to an increase in the capacity. Because the co-channel interference is decreasing, it will lead to an improvement in the signal quality. The signal quality improves because the co-channel interference is decreasing, and it also leads to an increase in the capacity. No degradation of the trunking efficiency. And some of the disadvantages of this particular concept is that more antennas are required in a microcell concept because we are dividing one cell into different zones and each zone will be needing a particular antenna, so more antennas are required, and the base stations need to be more sophisticated to handle the transfer of a call from one zone to the another, that too in a particular cell. That is, here we are not transferring the call from one cell to another, we are transferring the call from one zone to another, and all those zones will be located in one particular cell, so that needs to be taken care of. So this is all about a micro cell. If you have any questions, you can ask me. Thank you.